In the name of Allah, the gracious, the most merciful. Very, very good morning, students. We are starting chapter 22 of second year class, which is variations and genetics. Today we will discuss the first topic, which is about genes and alleles. Genes are the units of biological information. In the cells, nucleus is present. In the nucleus, chromatin material exists. Chromatin material consists of chromosomes. When cells are dividing, this chromatin material condenses to form chromosomes. And chromosomes are composed of two types of materials, DNA and proteins. DNA is the deoxyribonucleic acid. And so, genes are actually the parts of DNA. DNA is a genetic material, heredity material. It can transfer from parents to offspring. Similarly, genes can also transfer from parents to offspring in its gametes. Half genes comes from male gamete and half genes comes from female gametes. Similarly, half chromosomes come from male parent and half chromosomes come from female parent. And so, genes are the parts, are the units which are located on the chromosomes. They are units of character. All types of activities, whether it is morphological activities or physiological activities, all these activities are controlled, are determined by the genes. For example, shape of seeds, height of an organism, height, color, shape. Similarly, all the activities, all the metabolic activities which are controlled by the enzymes, they are determined by the genes which are present in the cells. And so, genes code for proteins. And so, the set of genes, which is known as the genotype, the genetic complement, it determines the phenotype and production of the proteins, enzymes, hormones. All are under control of our nucleus, because in the nucleus, the heredity material, DNA, is present, and the genes are the units of biological information. They are the parts of DNA. And so, at least two genes represent one character. Now, we will define gene. Genes and alleles. Firstly, we will define the genes. Gene is a basic unit of biological information. The sequence of nucleotides the sequence of the nucleotides that determines the amino acid sequence of a protein is called gene. And so, genes give information. Genes give instructions for the synthesis of proteins and enzymes. And structural proteins are functional proteins, and genes determine our phenotype. And so genes may be similar or different. They are present on homologous chromosome in the nucleus of the cell. The similar chromosomes are present in pairs. Two similar chromosomes are known as the homologous chromosomes. And genes are present at a specific position, at a specific place. And this position of the gene is called locus. And so, storage of information. All sorts of information is stored in the DNA, in the genetic material, which can be transmitted from one generation to the other generation. And so, basically, genes are the sequences of nucleotides. And so, in fact, DNA stores all sorts of information coded in a sequence of its bases. And nucleotides are composed of nitrogen bases, deoxyribose sugar, and phosphate group. And so, coded in a sequence of its bases in linear order. Genes are present in linear order. See in the diagram, see in the figure, small d shows homozygous alleles. They are same alleles. And capital C and small c, they are heterozygous, and they are the different genes. They are the different genes. And so capital A and small a, they are the different genes. They are the alleles. They are alleles of each other. And so capital D are same genes, are a pair of genes. And so hereditary characteristics pass from parents to offspring through genes in their gametes. And so half the genes come from mother and half genes comes from father. And so when the gametes unite together, zygote is formed. And so all sorts of characteristics, all the properties are transferred from one generation to the other generation, from the parents to the offsprings. Gene locus, the position of a gene. The position of a gene on chromosome is called gene locus. A typical human chromosome contains 140 million nucleotides, 140 million nucleotides in its DNA. And so it is a very huge number, because the properties and the characteristics and the characters of the organisms are also in large number. And so genes are also present in large number. Please note it. Now we discuss about the properties of genes. The basic property of genes is the transference of various characters from one generation to the other generation. We observe that the offsprings of the same parents have same characters in many cases. Many activities are same in the offspring of one parents. Their behavior is similar, but some activities, some functions, some traits, some characters are also different because genes can mutate. Genes can shift from one place to other place. We have studied now jumping genes, hopping genes, and you also know that during gamete formation, meiosis takes place. And when meiosis takes place, in the meiosis, crossing over between the non-sister chromatids occur. During crossing over, there is shuffling of genes. There is the exchange of segments, exchange of genes during crossing over. And when genes exchange between the non-sister chromatids, non-parental type combinations can be produced. Some combinations are parental type and other combinations are non-parental types. And so variations can also occur in those organisms which reproduce sexually. For example, human beings reproduce sexually. The offspring of the same parents is not exactly similar. They vary in many characteristics, in many characters, in many activities, because the offsprings are produced sexually, and so variations also takes place due to mutations in the genes. And when there is mutation occur in genes, alleles are formed. And so we will discuss alleles next. And so now we discuss the properties of the genes. Genes are responsible for producing startling inherited resemblances. Startling means very surprised inherited resemblances. Resemblances mean similarities. Many characters are similar in offsprings and parents. And so when the parental type gene combinations are transferred from parents to offspring, the resemblances results, similarities results, same type of activities results. And when genes mutate, when mutation occurs, reshuffling occurs, hopping, jumping of the gene occurs, variation takes place. So in this case, startling inherited resemblances as well as distinctive variations among generations. Variations are produced in sexually reproducing organisms due to recombination and crossing over and shuffling of the gene and mutation of the genes. And so, number two, when genes passes in the form of intact, means complete, intact parental combinations. When genes are transferred in the form of parental combinations, the resemblances results, similarities are produced. So, in the form of intact parental combinations between generations, inherited similarities are conserved. Those characteristics which are present in the parents, they must be conserved. They cannot be changed. Many types of activities are same, are similar in parents and offspring, in progeny. And variations also take place everywhere, especially during sexual reproduction. And number three, when genes shuffle, mutate, or juggle with each other, variations emerges. Variation takes place due to mutation, due to shuffling or reshuffling of the genes. Changes in the genes takes place. Changes in the sequence of nucleotides takes place. When changes in the genes takes place, variations are produced. And so unique characteristics are produced in the offspring as compared to their parents. You understand my point? And so, next, jumping genes. Jumping genes do not settle peacefully on their loci. Those genes which jump from one position to the other position on the same chromosome or on different chromosomes, they also produce variations. These jumping genes do not stay peacefully on one locus, on one position. They can jump, and when they can jump, variations occur. When they jump, changes in the sequence of nucleotides occur. And when changes in the genes or sequences of the nucleotides occur, the variations occur, the characteristics are changed as compared to the parents. And so, genotype actually determines the phenotype. And when genotype is changed, phenotype automatically changes, because genotype represents phenotype. Genotype produces phenotype. The color, shape, skin color, structures, and other activities can be produced due to genotype. All types of the traits are produced due to the action of genes, due to the role of genotype, role of genetic complement. Jumping genes do not settle peacefully on their loci. They keep on hopping on different loci on the same chromosome or other chromosome. And number fifth, these are the properties of genes. And number five, genes form pairs on pairs of homologous chromosomes. Genes form pairs on pairs of homologous chromosomes. On pairs of homologous chromosomes. Homologous chromosomes. The chromosomes are present in pairs, in homologous pairs, and so genes are also present on the chromosome. They are also present in pairs. One member of gene is located on one homologue, and the other member of the gene is present on the other homologue. One member of gene is located on one homologue and the other on other homologue and other homologue. When the chromosomes are transferred from parents to their progeny, and genes can also be transferred because genes are located on the chromosomes, and actually genes are the parts of DNA or hereditary material. These are the two homologous chromosomes, capital T, capital G, alleles of the same gene. And so capital T, capital G, these are the two genes. This is the pair of gene. One member is present one homologue, and the other member is present on the other homologue. And so during meiosis, the chromosomes number becomes half in the gametes, and so also the number of genes are reduced to half in the gametes. And when the gametes combine together, half genes or half chromosomes comes from male gamete, and the other half, the half number of genes, comes from the other gene, from the other gamete. And so zygote is formed, and from the zygote, new offspring or progeny is formed. Zygote is the first cell of the next generation. And so these are the properties of the genes. And please note it. Now we discuss about alleles. Alleles are the alternative forms of a gene. The chromosomes are present in pairs in the form of homologous pair of chromosomes, and so genes are also present on the chromosome in pairs. We have studied in the properties this point, we have studied. And so every character is represented a pair of alleles. For example, capital R is an allele for tallness, and small r is an allele for shortness of plants. Capital T and small t. R represent round seed shape in pea plant, and small r represent wrinkled seed shape. This is the round seed and this is the wrinkled seed. And so every character is represented at least two alleles. So alleles are formed due to mutations. For example, if this is the capital R for round seed, when mutation takes place, small r is produced. Similarly, when small t is mutated, if mutation takes place in small t, capital T is formed, or vice versa. Mutation alleles are produced as a result of mutations. And so partner of a gene pair occupying on same locus called alleles. These are the two homologous chromosomes, and so the genes are present on specific positions on specific loci of the chromosome. And so capital T alleles of the same gene, small a, they are present at the same locus. These are the loci of the genes or alleles. So these are capital T and capital A are different genes. capital P, they are the homozygous dominant alleles, dominant alleles. If one dominant allele is present in a pair, it shows itself. And if the other member is recessive, recessive allele does not show its phenotype. And so if two recessive alleles are present at a time, they show their cells. For example, capital R represent the round color, and small r represent the wrinkled, round shape, and small r represents the wrinkled shape. And so recessive alleles, when present in homologous form, in homozygous form, they show themselves. And the dominant allele, if present in heterozygous form, one allele is dominant and other is recessive. So dominant allele shows itself and recessive allele is masked by the dominant allele. And so capital G small g are heterozygous alleles, capital B are homozygous dominant alleles. The capital the capital letter is for dominant and small letter is for recessive. Small d homozygous recessive alleles. And so each allele of a gene pair occupies on the same gene locus on its respective homologue. Capital D on the same locus. Capital A, small a, they are located on the same locus. Capital B, they are located on the same locus. And so, because they show a same trait. Each allele of a gene pair occupies the same gene locus on its respective homologue. Both alleles on one locus may be identical or different from each other. And these two alleles, capital T, are identical, and small d are also identical. And so capital C and small c, they are not identical, they are different alleles. They are the alternative forms of each other. Capital R, small r, and capital D, small d, these are the alternative forms of a same gene. And so, this is the concept of the allele. And thank you very much. Note it, please, and then I will discuss. And now we discuss about phenotype and genotype. Phenotype is a form of appearance of a trait. Phenotype is a form of appearance of a trait. Of a trait. For example, seed shape, seed color, size of the plant, tall plant, dwarf plants, pod color, pod shape, flower position, skin color, these are all phenotypes, and these phenotypes are determined by the genes, by the alleles. And so And then we will discuss about the genotype. Genotype. Genotype is the genetic complement. Genetic complement of individual, that is genes in an individual for a particular trait. That is genes which are present in an individual in an individual, all the genes. Genes which are present in an individual for a particular trait. For a particular trait. For example, R is the gene which is for the red color, and so capital R is the genotype, for a red color. Because R is for redness. R is for redness. And small r is for white color. And so, I told you that at least two alleles represent one character. They may be homozygous dominant or homozygous recessive, and they may be heterozygous. They may be in a heterozygous condition. And so, if the genotype is capital R, it represents red color. If it is small r, this is for white color. This genotype determines white color. Similarly, if it is capital R, this is the heterozygous form of genotype of allele. It represents the red because capital R is dominant and small r is recessive. When these two alleles are present in combination, dominant allele represents itself and the recessive allele is masked. This does not show its character. And so when there is capital R, small r, seed color is red, or we can say that These are the genotypes. So small r for red and capital R for small r for whiteness and the capital R for the redness. See over here, capital C, small c, heterozygous alleles. When both alleles are recessive, they are the homozygous recessive alleles. When the both alleles are dominant, and so they are the homozygous dominant alleles. Capital B, capital B are the homozygous dominant alleles. And so flower color, I take the example of the flower color. Flower color is a trait. Flower color is a trait, and red and white are the two phenotypes, and red and white are two phenotypes. Are two phenotypes. Each form of appearance is determined by different alleles. Each form of appearance, each form of appearance is determined by different allele. I have given you the example that capital R represent the redness. Red flower color is determined by the capital R, and white flower color is represented by the small r. And so at the end we can say that genotype determines the phenotype. All the characteristics which are present in an organism, they are controlled and they are determined by the genes or alleles. And so these are the units of characters, biological units of inheritance. They are composed of genes, and alleles are composed of deoxyribonucleic acid. Actually, they are the parts of the DNA. Genes are the parts of the DNA. And so, whole the phenotype, whole the appearance of any plant or an animal is due to the functions of the genes or alleles. Thank you very much.